Hello everyone, GameOnBrad here, and this is World of Warcraft. Tonight, I'll be playing on my Warlock for the first time in a while. I play the affliction spec, and I'm going to give this a shot doing the dailies in the Tanaan Jungle. This is the first caster I'm really using in the Tanaan Jungle, so we'll see what happens. I've run my Warlock through here once, but I didn't really do too much in the way of combat. I just wanted to kind of test his abilities to see, like, what he would do, like, if he was okay. I changed a few things. I've got the Grimoire of Supremacy, so I've got a more powerful minion. So I picked the Infernal for AoE. That may change. It all depends on how this goes.
I need to target.
I'm running affliction, so it's a little different. Things will be, I guess, no less explosive, but
I need a target.
Involves a lot of attacks that just drain life out of the enemy. I'm not sure. This is my first time using the Infernal. I'm not sure how much the Infernal can take. Oh, this guy has got, this guy's a Warlock as well, but he's just using the Void minion.
I need to get closer.
Affliction's pretty good, but you have to really maintain your dots on targets. So it's constantly watching your dots. And you have to switch targets a lot. And put dots on pretty much everything. Luckily, my Infernal is AoE, but so are my attacks. With the Tanaan Jungle, you're going to want to be careful if you play a Warlock because you are going to get swarmed. You can try to do it specific targets, but you might get screwed by that. So you have to be careful. And try to take some skills at least that do AoE. Like, I took Phantom Singularity, which is a talent. Normally I wouldn't in a raid setting, even though if there's a lot of trash you should. But basically, it puts a dot over a specific target and then all targets around him take AoE damage. Which is great for Tanaan Jungle because you do get swarmed a lot. So I basically just drop it on guys when they get a little bit too close to my Warlock. Because he will die very easily. Whoa, all these guys are respawning really fast. So I'm going to go for more orb? Nope, I will. People are being quite nice tonight. It's really busy, but people are not kill stealing, and there is one jerk here who keeps destroying the orbs before I can destroy the minions, which kind of steals the kill from me. Wow, the Infernal is actually doing pretty damn well. I may use him quite a bit. This guy's a little bit tougher even though he's not at full health. So he may take a little bit longer to kill. Ah, my mana's running low. I'm gonna have to life tap. This guy is he just running around tagging everything? I think he is. He's just running around tagging all the mobs. That eye detected me, but we're killing everyone so fast here that it doesn't really matter. No one's gonna be aggroed to me. Normally these eye sentries, when they get aggroed, if you haven't cleared out enough cultists in this area, all these cabalists, they will turn around and start lynching you, like all of them. Oh, not all of them, but you might get five or six on you at one time. And because they're all casters, they'll start hitting you from range from different directions. Then you get a big shit. He can aggro as much as he likes, not gonna do much. People might be waiting for... There's a couple of bosses that spawn in the same location. People might be waiting for that. As long as I'm draining life, I could personally tank at least one guy hitting on me. I'll be okay as long as I'm draining life from something. Which is the key for Affliction Warlock now, I guess, is that you could basically tank if your drain life is good enough. Now he's just being a jerk.
Don't have a target.
In dungeons and raids, I obviously wouldn't use this Infernal. Unless I really needed AoE. But I find that rarely happens in a dungeon.
I need a target.
Somebody's flying around helping me out. See, once you drop your phantom, singularity on a group of mobs, they go down so fast. It's quite nice, actually. It may not be amazing, I guess, for DPS and raids, but adventuring in an area, it comes in really handy if you get swarmed. See, so I've got three guys on me because I let the sentry detect me. Bad thing about Phantom Singularity is if you put it on a guy that insta-dies, then it's kind of useless. If you got a boss with a lot of mobs, though, it's a lot easier to do. Like, take for instance, if you've seen my other videos and you've seen me go through the temple area, there's a rare mob that is a female blood elf, and she has imps with her. And she keeps summoning them the entire time you're fighting with her. So Phantom Singularity would be amazing for that. Not too bad. It's actually pretty easy. I'm a little surprised.
Get something first.
There we go. Oops, wrong mount. The mount you're seeing me ride right now is a giant bat mount, and I bought that from the Blizzard store just because it looks so damn cool, and it's like the perfect mount for a warlock. It looks demonic. Oh, it's so great. Alright, so I have to kill 22 more Iron Horde, which should be doable here. Based on my dailies with my other guys, I'm going to have to come back here to defeat one of the big guys. So that'll be a nice challenge, especially if nobody's helping me. That'll be a nice challenge to see how the Infernal holds up against the big elite guys that are here. Oh, what am I doing? I can't finish this yet. Why won't he tag? Tried to tab target him, but he wouldn't tab target. Can't do anything to me, buddy. One on one? You're out of your league. He is healing, but the one good thing about Phantom Singularity is these guys, because they keep healing, if he can outheal my damage I'm doing, even with Phantom Singularity, I can kill every enemy that goes after my Infernal around him. So we're good there. Oh, here's a flag. Might as well work on this a little bit.
Oh,
the Affliction Warlock with 7.0.3 patch, the rotations become a lot shorter. I only basically have five skills that I work off of. I do have a Feldguard that I can summon, or Doomguard that I can summon, but I don't normally use it unless I'm in a pressured situation. So I just keep it off to the edge here. I do have a Fell Hunter in the event that I change my Grimoire, so that I'm not using the bigger demons. Die already! Oh, you guys are so brutal. Your damn heals. I gotta heal my minion finally. Luckily, he heals up pretty quick. I don't even have to move my Infernal. His aggro just keeps aggroing everything. Like, they just keep coming. It's hilarious. I'm gonna have to stop this eventually. I also talented into corruption. There's a talent now that gives corruption permanence. So when I cast it on an enemy, it's on them for as long as they're alive, which is quite nice. Originally it's for 14 seconds and the tooltip still shows 14 seconds, but that's not actually the case. Can't kill me, buddies. There's no way. Because of my drained life healing so much of my health, I can't die. They would have to literally gank me. It would have to be three or four people at once would have to come at me to really take me out. Why are you coming at me? Okay, I'm gonna turn off his taunt. Because he keeps aggroing everything. This guy is pretty crazy. Alright. Let's find a place where we could rest for a sec. And we will teleport back. We'll turn in those two quests, and then we'll get the two objectives that we have to do. And I still haven't got a single Apexis fragment. It is so busy tonight.
I am here for you.
It seems like every single weeknight, the past 2 weeks, has been insane. There are so many players that are on every single night. I've run into... Today, there were three different players that haven't played WoW in years, and they finally came back to play. And it's all because of the announcement of
the
Legion.
Eternal Sun guides us.
And what they have planned for Legion. People have either read up on it, or they love demons like I do. Okay, so I have to do two bonus objectives, and I have to get a harness from the big guy. So I'm going to see It's actually faster me flying directly with my mount than it is taking a flight point, I believe. But I'm going to go after one of the big elite guys in the Iron Front. Typically would avoid them, but I'm very curious. Because there's several things I'm going to have to watch for. The Iron Front has so many Iron Horde that spawn all around you, especially in nights like this, because there are so many players killing things that it's almost insta-spawn. So I'm going to have to fight the big guy while watching all around me, because something is going to spawn and attack me, just like when I got stuck in those chain kills. So we'll see what happens now. I'll do the Iron Front, and I guess on the way back I could do the Fell Forge or something. Or the Harbor. The Iron Harbor is pretty cool too. When Legion launches, they've already revealed that there will be... These are basically kind of like World Quests, and I guess this is World Quest 1.0. In Legion, it's going to be World Quest 2.0. And, oh, somebody's fighting this guy. I might as well do it the easy way. So in World Quest 2.0, they've already said that Legion will have 1,000 World Quests at the start. Oh, one of the rare guys is up. The zone bosses. So they said they're going to have 1,000 World Quests ready to go. They'll cycle in every 3 hours. And on top of that, there will be rep world quests for the different reps, reputation factions that are in Legion, that will spawn in every 6 hours. So there's always going to be something for you to do. And when you consider 1,000 world quests, they've already said that you're likely to see the same boss from a world quest once every 3 months. So that's pretty crazy. So it's not going to be boring, and the levels will scale, which is incredible. Like, that's what Guild Wars 2 does, and I hope they've used that method that Guild Wars 2 uses for this. Because that is a brilliant idea if they do that. Might as well summon my Doomguard. Look at how many players there are. I never see this many players. They're all over the place. Ah, just oil. Okay, so now we'll go back to the... I guess I could do this daily because it's 24% in. But I want to kill Iron Horde. They're so much fun to kill. And the Iron Front is very, it gets my heart going, because it's just, there's so many mobs all around you that you don't get tired of it. You're constantly adapting to the situation. And there's bosses that pop up here too, just seemingly out of nowhere. Oh, I forgot, if I summon my Fell Guard or my Doom Guard, it's going to remove my...
I don't have a target.
It's going to remove my Infernal. Ah, crap. Ah! Why are they trying to bomb me all of a sudden? They're just being mean. Alright, let's switch back to the Infernal. Alright, so I gotta remove him from my taskbar. Just to make sure I don't do that again. What? How did somebody else aggro this guy, but he attacked me? Oh, my Infernal. My Infernal taunted him. But I have taunt turned off. Oh, no, I don't. Or did I? At least the other warlock was nice about it and he came back. See, so you see lots of different warlocks here tonight as well. It turns out the warlocks are really great for this area. As long as you have a minion that can pull aggro off you, you'll be good. Even the footsteps of my minion has weight to it. It's pretty cool. Why isn't my tap targeting working? That's so weird. There it goes, trying to drink his healing elixir. They have this elixir they drink, and if you don't stop them from drinking it, they start healing at an incredible rate. Oh wait, is he still up? He's about to come down. I'll bring my minion back. Come back here. Why are you staying over there? There we go. Waiting for him to come down. He's gonna die so fast. Usually he could be troublesome to fight when you're just fighting him on your own, but if you're geared, you're good. Here we go. Very well, I should come down and solve this myself. Oh, that's a mage spell, I believe. See, he's gonna go down in no time. Look at that. Between the mages and the warlocks and the tanks, he's dead. It's amazing. I'm in combat with the big guy now because he hit me with his AoE. Guess I'm gonna get my wish to see what it's like to fight him. Hey, I like my minion's name. My minion, I don't choose the name, I don't believe. He's called Torch Burst. That's pretty cool. Oh yeah. Oh, there was another player helping me out. I thought my minion was doing a fantastic job. It turns out I was getting help. He's got a minion ogre from his garrison. He's got a companion. Alright, so we're done here. Only got two fell fragments in this whole exchange. There's usually chests lying around here, but it looks like people are scooping them up faster than I can see them. Oh well, what can you do? Alright, so let's go back to the Iron Harbor and kill some more guys. Oh wait, there's a boss there. Let's close this. Great. I've got another enemy aggroed to me. I could do Phantasm on top of him. Why not? Okay, this is at 21%. There's a lot of people here, so why not? I'll just stay here and kill these guys. What's that? You're hacking at me? Well, that's not gonna do much. Phantasm isn't up right now. Or Phantom Singularity. That's okay.
I need a target.
Go. My demon is a bit of a shit disturber when it comes to his aggro. My guy is not super well geared. He's like 663, which is pretty good. But for a caster, I would be more comfortable in the Tanaan Jungle with about, I'd say, 680 item level. But when you first come to Tanaan Jungle, you're not going to have that, so it's kind of pointless to even say. You're probably going to come here with like a 600 to 650. Keep forgetting how powerful these guys are. The Overseers are just pretty crazy. They have so much health. I don't want that eye sentry catching me down here. Down there is a death trap. If you get stuck down there and an eye sentry hits you, you get about 10 guys turning towards you all at once. This guy too has really good amount of health. Well, damn it. The eye sentry spawns right here. So he's gonna keep spawning the longer I stand here to kill this guy. See? He just keeps spawning in that one spot. I'll maybe pick another area. We can go back up there. His footsteps are so loud to me. It'll be much quieter for you watching this because I've turned it down in the actual video editing, but trust me, his footsteps are very loud. Let's put set. There we go. I always go up where all the Cabalists are, but I thought this would be a nice change of pace. Just come down here. do something a little different. Not sure I love unstable affliction very much. It's just okay. Go. Might be able to kill them both at once. Okay, maybe not. But close. Oh, shit. I ran out of mana. I forgot the life tap. My bad. Oh, crap. Gotta get him before he... Yes. If you see three little exclamation marks appear over the eye's head, it's alerting nearby enemies of me. Oh, got him just in time. I think that eye spawns right here. So they can sneak up on you quite easily. There it is. Oh! Did he alert anybody? Oh, good. Nobody was close enough. Ah, crap. Guys should die pretty quick. He's got his eye on me. Just gonna go around him and let him track his path. Uh-oh. Accidentally aggroed that guy. So I'm going to keep moving around. You'll see me move around a lot more with my Warlock when I'm not channeling Siphon Life. It's just because I don't want to aggro too many guys with my Warlock. I got to constantly be looking around. Whoa! I don't have... I must have phased into another shard, with a bunch of different worlds. So that was very abrupt. Yeah, suddenly it's like all empty here. I guess I switched servers, I guess? Hey, no fair. I was having fun killing those guys. There's those damn eyes again. Where's that other one? It must be still tracking. It was here somewhere, I just don't see it. Surprisingly, a lot of people don't realize that these Cabalists are attached to their blood orb. If you kill the blood ritual orb, you kill the Cabalist, but you don't get the kill or any loot drop from it if you do that. So somebody who's technically helping you out could actually hinder you. Just drop a bunch of... This Ice Mage is very helpful. He must be doing his 25 vials quest or something. I believe if you actually need your quest for that, you can attack somebody else's target and still get credit for the loot. At least that's the way it seems to be right now. If they made that change and announced it, I don't remember seeing it. But it's a nice touch because there's so many people farming these areas. Go back down here. Fell minion. You Infernals look so cool now. I'm so glad they changed them. Let's send him in first. Go. Oh, there's a Death Knight behind him. I was like, wow, I'm doing really great DPS. No, there's a Death Knight there. He was helping me out. Okay, let's just fly up. Whoa. Hello, gentlemen. You guys seem very angry. Maybe I could suggest a therapist for your anger management issues. Wow, these guys are angry. Let's reapply. Add unstable affliction. There we go. Tap. Wow, these guys respawn in here already. Gonna see lots of numbers popping up here because I added Phantom Singularity to this attack. Phantom Singularity, in addition to my dots and my Siphon Life or Drain Life, it adds tons of just numbers all over the screen. Oh, this should be fun. Send him in. All right, let's dot them all. There we go. I'll have to give my Infernal a little bit of healing. They can't out. Oops. Keep forgetting that my corruption is unlimited now. Keep trying to reapply it. A boss spawns right at the foot of this tower as well. Oh, damn you. Almost done, and then I just need 5 fell corrupted fragments. And then I'm done? So not too bad. I'm actually more comfortable using the Warlock now in the Tanaan Jungle. I was worried about bringing him in here and just failing horribly. But he actually doesn't do too bad. I'm pretty impressed. Oh, can I get to the orb before he responds? Done. So I won't turn these in yet. I'm gonna look for bosses now. Or chests. Either or. They can pretty much spawn anywhere. There's certain locations they spawn most frequently. Oh, is that? Yep, that's the elite guy. Let's fight him. He should give me a fell corrupted fragment. Gave me two. Excellent. Already have seven. Aw, crap. I don't want to get stuck here fighting these guys again. Fly! Fly! God damn it! I can't destroy the orbs too because I've done the objective for this area. So they would just keep spawning on me. Let's go back to the iron front. There's usually some guys over there. The jungle below me here often has a lot of bosses too. I think there's three of them down there, but they're farmed quite heavily the moment they spawn. Wow, it's eerily silent here. Okay, I need another chest then if I can't find a boss. Oh, there's a chest. Excellent. One more. That's all I need. Either a boss or a chest. Try over here. Sometimes there's chests in these little huts. Whoa. Sorry about that guy. Didn't mean to anger you. Just passing through. Sometimes they're on these tree stumps. Nope. They're not typically further over here. They're typically down this way. Oh, this boss is about to proc again. I don't know if I can get fragments from him twice in a day. I'm gonna try. I only need one anyway. The Alliance is taking this point this time, but I can still fight the boss. Here he comes. Go. Let's see if I can loot him now. I don't think I can, but maybe. Nope. Okay, so you can only loot the rares once per day. One thing you're going to find if you're coming back to WoW, doing these dailies to build your rep in this area is great, but you're going to have... Oh, there's a chest. You're going to have a lot of competition. My Infernal's AoE doesn't really do all that much damage. Sometimes I'll get a player coming here and stealing this chest before I can get to it. Excellent. All right, and with that, we're done. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Hi everyone, I just want to say thank you very much for watching this video. Please give this video a like and please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I'll be posting many more videos in the future. Thank you very much and have a fantastic day.